So Charles, when Dr. Sechenov sends his twins somewhere on an assignment with, say, Stockhausen, he's guarded by that red monster?
Makes sense. Comrade Stockhausen is incapable of independently reaching his destination within a facility swarming with hostile robots, and Sechenov would never remain unguarded.
Why? He's a hero of the Soviet Union. Everybody loves the guy. Why would anybody want to hurt him?
Why indeed, Comrade Major?
You think there are people in the Kremlin who are jealous of him and want to get rid of him?
It's more likely that they just want power over... If you rule the world, it's hardly surprising if people want to take your throne. Very powerful people.
I'd rather have Dr. Sechenov be the General Secretary of Collective than anybody else.
The General Secretary? Is that what you think he's going to be?
Of course. What else would he be?
I hope you're right.
Charles, how could that prick Petrov send intel to the West? The facility's under lockdown.
Petrov cannot transfer anything directly to anyone, or he would have already done so. That is why he is attempting to deceive Collective Central Control Hub.
Are you talking about that big-ass ball floating in the sky? You mean Petrov's somewhere close by?
I believe so. The emergency protocol has blocked most communication between Facility 3826 and the outside world. This block cannot be overcome. An entire science... Academy would be required, such as the Academy of Consequences.
Then what's he hoping to accomplish?
As you have no doubt already observed, there is one communication channel connected to the outside world that is not subject to the emergency protocol.
The secret government line.
Quite right. That channel is used by Dr. Sechenov to contact the Kremlin. No one else has access to it.
Yeah, no one except Granny Zina. So, what's Petrov trying to pull?
I believe he is trying to dupe the Central Hub by passing himself off as Dr. Sechenov.
That son of a bitch. Charles, is there really a chance Petrov could fool the Hub? It wasn't exactly programmed by morons, right? They must have put protections in place.
Petrov is a talented engineer and programmer. There's a reason he made it to Facility 3826. He's the one who optimized the programmer-to-robot and robot-to-robot digital data transfer protocols.
So he knows better than anyone how the... So he knows better than anyone else. So he knows better than anyone how the Central Hub works. Does that mean Petrov could actually fool the Hub? Then why did Dr. Sechenov trust these protocols to a single guy?
It's temporary. After the launch of Collective 2.0, digital communication channels will be rendered useless and irrelevant. Everything will be transmitted via neuropolymer wave emission. Binary code will be left in the dustbin of history.
And so will programmers. No. Wonder Petrov is so pissed. He wants to fuck shit up while he still can.
In broad strokes, although I suspect that Petrov has other motives.
He's a traitor to the motherland. Fuck his motives. How long do we have to stop him?
Hacking Collective Central Hub is a very difficult task. Even with the right communication equipment. Petrov will need considerable time to do it.
So where can he find that kind of equipment, other than the Science Center?
Only aboard the Flying Chelomei Complex.
And nowhere else? That's great. Your goose is cooked now, Petrov, you traitorous dickhead.
No time to lose.
Please select the desired procedure. Authorization.
Data. Was he Newt's son? I'm sorry. Tá desde o começo. Nesse momento que né? Se aparecer alguma coisa melhor que desmontar ela e já era.
Ah, another dungeon.
This is the testing ground, Major. There should be weapons here.
Testing ground, dungeon, same difference. Let's find the stuff and get moving.
Essas balas morram aqui que dá bastante item.
The dreams and aspirations of Facility 3826's scientists know no bounds. The daring Soviet scholars want to know, how can I make a Soviet citizen's life in space as comfortable as possible? What conditions are key to making their stay outside of the Earth's atmosphere indistinguishable from what they're used to? Here, at Testing Ground 6, you can observe one such experiment. Will it be possible for future space-faring generations to watch movies in zero gravity? The answer is, naturally, for the Soviet citizen, nothing is impossible.
Thank you.
sí.
Thank you.
isn't Comrade Lutyagin.
You seem rather gloomy. Is something wrong?
No, I just feel like I had a bad dream or something. And this guy was there.
Pull yourself together. You haven't slept in a long time, Major.
I feel like I'm asleep right now and I'm having a nightmare.
It's no nightmare. It's a mirage.
So, what will it be, Major? This turbine serves both as a hype facility for teams of WSP-9s and as an actuator for the generator that supplies power to the testing ground's mechanical staff.
Vodka.
Thank you.
Testing Ground 6's planning department is responsible for 1. Obtaining and supporting solutions for the construction of future testing workshops. 2. Producing construction designs for the reconstruction, repair, and construction of new buildings. 3. Producing design specifications and estimates for construction jobs. And 4. Preparing planning-related statements of work. Authorization.
Thank you.
desculpa.
Hey, Sergey! Are you okay, man?
Desgraçado! just got sovereign.
Not bad.
It will get better, Comrade Major.
Was that a joke? At whose expense? Let's get going.